Hi everyone, so today I'm going to be showing you how to color correct slash fix any dark patches in your ombre. It is a little different than when you're fixing dark patches in a regular all one tone colored hair, because in that case you can just put a dye over what you already have and that kind of fixes the problem. With an ombre, the process is a little different. More if you feel like the color is getting a little bit too low, or if you want to lighten your tips. This is a technique that I actually picked up on YouTube. I was looking at a whole bunch of different hair artists and people who specialize in ombres, and they were doing like the balayage technique and different techniques to cover up dark patches. So what I did was I looked at a whole bunch of videos and I picked up all the little techniques that made sense to me and that I feel like would work for you to be able to do it at home and actually make it possible for you. So I picked up all those techniques and I just clustered them up into one video so that you guys can see how to do that at home. So yeah, if you wanna see how to color correct and patch up your ombre, please keep watching. So first, you want to just start off by parting your hair into four even pieces. This is just going to allow you to have a better grip on your hair and to be able to divide it evenly so that you don't miss any of those dark patches. You do want to make sure that as you go, you are untangling your hair, because having knots in your hair can cause even more patching than what you already have. And I am using Loreal Color Excellence Cream. And just a regular black brush from Sally's. So as you can see, the technique that I'm using is I am starting in the middle. So I put the brush in the middle and I just comb up so that there are no harsh lines created within the ombre. And then at the tips, I just bring the color down regularly. And from the middle up, I whisk it up. In this section of my hair, you can really see where the dark patches are. It's kind of like around the middle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start again in the middle of my hair and just run the color up a little bit to reduce the harsh lines. And then even though I'm doing that, I'm focusing most of the dye and most of the color onto where the dark patches are. And I'm just going to repeat the same technique all around my hair. I am going to speed up the process, but again, it's just the same technique. You start in the middle, whisk it up, and focus just on the dark patches for the most color. In this clip, you can see a lot of dark patches, but again, same technique. Just start in the middle and concentrate most of your color on the dark areas. Thank you.
Here what I did was I mixed in my second box dye because I did use two boxes. The reason why I waited until the end, right before starting the front part to mix that, is because when you have a dye sitting for more than about 20 minutes, it loses its potency, so you might not get the same color effect. So yeah, you always want to make sure that you're mixing your dyes right before you use them to get the most effective results. And I started crying because the smell of the fumes in my face were just too harsh.
Okay, so this is the final result of my hair after I did the color correcting slash dark patch cover up at home. I did wait about 2 weeks before filming this section of the video, the introduction part of the video, after I did the dye on my hair. And the reason why I did that is because I have noticed that with my hair, at least, when I dye my hair, it does take a couple of washes before I can actually see the real result and what my hair is actually going to look like after that dye. So I have washed my hair a couple of times and I've styled it a couple of different ways. And yes, I have noticed a very big difference with the dark patches that you noticed while I was dyeing it. I am able to part my hair in different ways now and do different styles and not have those dark patches showing through. So this technique worked for me, it worked for my hair type, and it was extremely successful for me to do it at home. It had so many dark patches that I just couldn't deal with it. If you guys wanna try this at home, please comment below. Let me know if there's anything that you think I should add to my technique, or if there's anything that I missed, anything that works, doesn't work, so that people who are going to be doing this in the future and they look at the comment bar, they're like, all right, so I'll avoid this or I'll avoid that, or if I have this hair type, I will try this. And again, if I do anything or if I show any techniques that you feel like will not work for your hair because you don't have curly hair or you don't have long hair or you just don't like box dyes, if there's anything that you feel like you would want to do different from what I did in this video, like I said, I did pick up a lot of these little techniques on YouTube myself, looking at other hairstylists and people who do ombres for a living. So you can just Google Ombre, Google Balayage, look it up, search it on YouTube, and you're gonna get like a million results of people who are doing ombres, and you can look it up by hair type, you can look it up by hair color, by ombre color technique, and it'll just show you a million results of anything that you may be looking for. So please rate, comment, and subscribe. And if you want to see any other videos from my channel, please let me know below, and I will be filming more. I hope you guys like what you see.